Praise God for the Prince of Peace. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Hallelujah. The Lord been dealing with me about talking on the spirit of witchcraft. I most of the time preach about it, but the Lord said preach about the spirit of witchcraft. Praise God. Don't like to talk about it, but there's so many witches and warlocks who are roaming the earth. First of all, I want to thank those down all around the world who have sent to my Cash App, Flame of Fire 8, under Pastor Warren Adams. May God turn your decrease into increase. God said, I will bless you. When you keep my holy commandments, I will bless you. Deuteronomy 28, verse 1 to verse 14. God said, I will bless you. Read the whole verse. He said, I make you the head and not the tail. I make you above only and not beneath. He said, I will bless you if you keep my commandments. And even though God was talking to Israel, but it also applied to the church today. So it applies, don't let it fly. Jesus said, if you love me, keep my commandments. But do not just serve the Lord only to get blessed, but serve the Lord because you love him. Serve him because he deserves to be served. Oh, I like that. God just gave me that just now. That should be a sermon in the future right there. Serve the Lord because he deserves to be served. Come on, tell somebody, YouTube land. God deserves to be served. Why? Jesus loved us. For God so loved the world, and he still do, that he gave his only begotten son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. Jesus loves sinners, but he does not love the sin. He loves us, but he doesn't love the things that we do when we sin against God, when we sin against his word. So Jesus made it possible that we could be saved from our sins, so we won't have to die and go to a devil's hell. He made it possible that we can repent. Repent means to stop, turn away from sin with godly sorrow. We are saved by grace and through faith. According to Hebrews chapter number 2, verse 8, thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Then Peter said unto them, praise God for the Prince of Peace. Repent and be baptized, every one of you. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. God bless you in the name of Jesus Christ for the remissions of sins, and he shall receive the gift of the Holy Ghost. The Holy Ghost is a promise that God has promised for you and your children. According to Acts chapter 1, verse 8, Acts chapter number 2, get a chance to read it. The reason why God gave us power, the Holy Ghost is Jesus Christ. Because the Lord already knows that the enemy will try all he can to try to get us back into sin. When you receive Jesus in your life, you're no longer a servant of sin. You no longer belong to the devil. You're not going to hell. But the devil is very tenacious. He doesn't give up. He wants to try to bring you back into bondage. He wants to try to bring you back into what God has delivered you from. That's why Apostle Paul said in the book of Galatians chapter 5 verse 1. He says, stand fast therefore in the liberty wherewith Christ hath made you free. Here we go on to say, and be not entangled again in the yoke of bondage. In other words, don't go back into what the Lord has delivered you from. God has gave Apostle Paul the message to preach to the church and teach and to admonish the church about the spiritual weapons that God has given to his people. The weapons of our warfare is not carnal, but they mighty through God until the pulling down of strongholds. Apostle Paul talked about putting on the whole armor of God, that you may be able to stand against the wiles of the devil. According to Ephesians chapter number 6, verse number 10. Praise the Lord. God bless you. Happy to see y'all this morning. God is with y'all. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Praise God for the men of God. May God continue to bless them as they fight crime here in New Jersey. We're praying for you today, that God's angels will continue to watch over you. Praise God for them. Continue, Lord, to bless them, God, and protect them, God, and save them, God, and fill them with the power of your Holy Spirit, God, your love. He said, finally, my brethren, be strong in the Lord. See? Be strong in the Lord and in the power of his might. See? Verse 10 of Ephesians chapter number 6. They go on to say, put on the whole armor of God that you may be able to stand against the wiles of the devil. Because we wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against principalities and against powers, spirits of wickedness in high places. The enemy has placed the spirit of witchcraft not only in the world, but also in the church. Now, you would not expect witchcraft to be in the church. I grew up in church like many of you did. Those of you who never grew up in the church, but you're going to church now. You would never expect for witches to go to church. You would never expect for witches and warlocks to be on the pulpit. First of all, who are witches? Witches are people who practice witchcraft. Very simple. They go around putting curses on people. They deal with demonic spirits. They pray to evil spirits. Scary stuff. They were doing it even back in the days of Moses. God was even angry at witches back then in the days of Moses because they were so wicked and so evil. God was so angry at witches and warlocks that he told Moses in the book of Exodus chapter 22, verse 18, he said, suffer not a witch to even live. Now, we're not saying go around killing people, but that lets you know that God doesn't like witchcraft. Why? God is a good God. God is a loving God. God is a wonderful God. So you cannot expect a loving God to love evil. Thank God for a loving and wonderful God. We are blessed to have a God like you, God. For you are the great hope and not the Pope. And you don't have to take no dope. Jesus is a great hope. God was angry at wizards. Wizards are male witches. Harry Potter, male witch. Read the book of Leviticus chapter 19, verse 31. You said, regard not them, can I teach, who have familiar spirits, neither seek after the wizards, for I am the Lord your God, says the Lord. Israel was seeking wizards. Israel began to worship idols and statues, and God chose Israel to be the apple of his eye. He chose them out of all the nations back in the Old Testament. And the King James Version of the Old Testament, 39 books of the Old Testament, 27 books of the New Testament, all together is 66 books of the Bible. The Jews have something called the Hebrew Torah, which means the law of life. Praise God for the Prince of Peace. God gave Moses 613 commandments according to the Hebrew Torah to Moses on Mount Sinai. God chose Israel to be his first chosen people. God is calling the Gentiles here in the New Testament, the time of grace. Praise the Lord. For the law was given by Moses, but grace and truth came by Jesus Christ, Yeshua HaMashiach. According to St. John chapter 1, verse 17, but God was upset with Israel because they transgressed against the law that God gave Moses to give to Israel. God is against witchcraft, evil black magic. Let's get into the Bible. Let's get into the Word of God. What did the Bible say about witchcraft? A lot of us in the church, outside the church, it's all in Hollywood, it's on TV. These days you don't know who's a witch now because not every witch look like a witch. There are witches who are beautiful. There are wizards who are handsome because the Bible says that Satan transformed himself as an angel of light. You would not expect the devil to come pretty.
You would not expect the devil to come handsome, but he comes beautiful, because Lucifer was created by God not to be evil, not to be wicked, but Lucifer was created by God to be good. I want to clarify this before I go any further. God did not create Lucifer to be wicked. I want to clarify that. God made Lucifer to be good. It was Lucifer's choice to become wicked. That was not God's decision. Even though God already knew that Lucifer was going to come against him, God knows the future. Someone asked the question, well, why did God create him then? That's another subject. But he did. So he was cast out of heaven. Lucifer is now called Satan, the dragon. Jesus said he's a liar, and the Father lies, and the truth is not in him, and he was a murderer from the beginning. The fallen angels that Lucifer has deceived, half of the angels in heaven. He did not deceive all the angels. He deceived half of the angels in heaven. Deception started in heaven. God had Michael, the prince, the archangel, who was an angel of war. Michael, the archangel. Thank God for the prince. But Jesus is the prince of peace, who's above all princes. But God had Michael and his angels make war against the dragon, who's the devil, and his angels. So war started in heaven. Michael won. Good always win over evil. The devil's mad, so he put agents in the world. He put witches and warlocks in the world to put out demonic spirits to try to take the souls of people. But Jesus came to save your soul because he loves you. He's the Prince of Peace. If you got molested, Jesus can heal you. If you got raped, Jesus can heal you. God can save a drug addict and get him out the attic and make him a preacher. Woo! I felt that right there. Hallelujah. God can save a prostitute and make her a prophetess. That's how much God loves you. Praise God, bless you. Praise God for the Prince of Peace. So that God bless you. Gloria a Dios. Gracias Jesus. Jesus has open arms to embrace you with his love. You can come directly to Jesus Christ and say, Lord, I'm tired of being on drugs. I'm tired of being on crack. Many of you has been bound by witchcraft and demonic spirits. You've been having nightmares. You can't sleep at night. Some of your own mothers been doing witchcraft against you. Are your own fathers been doing Santeria on you? You say, Lord, I don't understand. Why would your own mother be jealous of you? It's the same, isn't it? You're not supposed to molest the child. You're supposed to protect the child. How are you putting curses on your own daughter? How are you trying to put curses on your own son? You're supposed to pray for your children, not do witchcraft on your children. Come on. But unfortunately, this goes on in and outside of church. What did the Bible say about witchcraft? Let's go into the Word of God. How did God feel about this? Since early times, people have sought supernatural experiences God did not endorse. You heard that? God did not endorse that. Talk about magic and all that stuff. God doesn't deal with magic. God doesn't deal with divinations. God's power is greater than magic. God's power is greater than divination. The Bible says not by might, it's not by power, but it's by my spirit, says the Lord. Not by magic. Not by witchcraft. Look at this. Since early times, people have sought supernatural experiences. God did not endorse the nations that surrounded the promised land were saturated with such practices. And God had stern words for his people. I just taught that, concerning any involvement with them. Read the book of Deuteronomy, chapter 18, verse number 9 to verse number 12. Oh Lord, it says that when you enter the land the Lord your God is giving you, do not learn to imitate the detestable ways of the nations. Don't imitate it. Praise the Lord. God bless you. Hallelujah. God gonna bless you today. God bless you. Hallelujah. Amen. You're too blessed to be stressed. Thank you, Jesus. She praising God right there. Feeling the Holy Ghost. He told Israel, don't imitate the heathen nations. Don't do witchcraft like they do. Don't worship idols like they do. For I am the Lord your God, says the Lord. He has stern words about that for his people concerning any involvement in witchcraft. God is against witchcraft and black magic. Go to the book of Deuteronomy, chapter 18, verse 9 to verse 12. It says, when you enter to the land, the Lord your God is giving you, do not learn to imitate the detestable ways of the nations there. Let no one be found among you who sacrifice their sons, our daughters, in the fire. That's evil. They're there sacrificing their sons and daughters and throwing them in the fire, sacrificing their children to the devil. God is against Molech, who's a statue that they was worshiping. Read the book of Leviticus, chapter number 20. You get a chance to, y'all. I'm going to keep reading here from the word. Who practice divinations, our sorceries, interpreters, omens. Omens are evil spirits. Omens. People who are omens make bad things happen. So you got to be careful who you call your friends. Someone got an omen demon. They make evil things happen. Let's get into God's word. The world call it jinx. That's what they call it. Let me get on the microphone so y'all can hear me. Because this thing in the background. Because the devil know I'm telling the truth. So I'm going to preach it. Omens are evil spirits. Jinx. In the world, they call it jinx. That's what they do. They call it jinx. Watch this. Who practice divination, sorcery, interpret omens, engage in witchcraft, I cast spells in the name of Jesus. Who is a medium, a spiritualist. God is against spiritualists. Who consult the dead. You're not supposed to consult dead people. God is not the God of the dead. He's the God of the living. It is. We're not putting down your deceased loved ones. It is y'all. Anyone who does these things, it is y'all. Anyone who does these things is detestable to the Lord. God hates it. God will be against you if you practice divination and sorcery and witchcraft and casting spells and consulting dead people and mediums and sorcerers. It is y'all. God takes witchcraft very seriously. He hates it. The penalty, now there's a penalty, y'all, which means punishment. The penalty for practicing witchcraft under the Masonic law was death. You hear that, y'all? The penalty for practicing witchcraft under the Masonic law was death. You hear that? Exodus chapter 22, verse 18. Look what God said. Suffer not a witch to even live. I see why. Because they're wicked and evil. You always get into your business. Someone said, well, I practice white magic. It's still magic. God is against magic. Whether you call it white magic or black magic, God is against magic, period. Don't be deceived. Let the Lord save your soul and break that contract that you signed with the devil so God can save you. Because the devil don't care nothing about you. Read the book of Leviticus chapter number 20, verse 27. First Chronicles chapter 10, verse 13 tells us that Saul died because he was unfaithful to the Lord. He did not keep the word of the Lord and even consulted a medium for guidance. God didn't like it. In the New Testament, sorcery is translated from the Greek word parmakia, which is spelled P-H-A-M-A-K-E-I-A, from which we get our word
pharmacy. Well, that's where it came from. That's deep. Galatians chapter 5, verse 20. Revelation chapter 18, verse 23. Witchcraft and spiritualism often involve the realistic use of magic, potions, and mind-controlling drugs. Using illicit drugs. That means there's witchcraft even in drugs. You heard that, y'all? Drugs is also a form of witchcraft. Demons are in drugs. Let the Lord deliver you from drugs. God's love can deliver you from drugs. You don't need no drugs. All you need is God's love. Because there are demon spirits that are in drugs that make people do bad things. It disintegrates your body. Using illicit drugs can open ourselves up to an invasion of demonic spirits. Engaging in a practice of taking a substance to achieve an altered state of consciousness is a form of witchcraft. You hear this? Hear this, y'all? Keep going. There are only two sources, I'm going to teach you, of spiritual power. God and Satan. Satan has only the power that God allows him to have. Praise the Lord. Oh, God bless you, man of God. That's so nice of you. Happy to see you again, my brother. God bless the man of God who just blessed me today. Ah, God bless him. God, that's my Spanish Holy Ghost brother. Thank you, G. One of my ministers. They open my church. I'm going to be baptizing people in Jesus' name. And thank God for you, handmaiden, for your word of prophecy. Praise God about the future church. Praise God. Thank God for prophetess and prophets. There are only two sources of spiritual power, God and Satan. Satan has only the power that God allow him to have, but it's considered. Look, read the book of Job, chapter 1, verse 12. 2 Corinthians, chapter 4, verse 4. Revelation, chapter 20, verse 2. To seek spirituality, knowledge, our power, apart from God, is idolatry. Closely related to witchcraft. It is now. Different forms of witchcraft. I'm going to tie this in with witches and warlocks, what they do, and how to recognize them. I'll give you some scriptures on this. Read the book of 1 Samuel, chapter 15, verse 23. Oh, Lordy, Lord. It says, for rebellion is as a sin of witchcraft. You hear that, y'all? Saul rebelled against God. He was disobedient. The prophet Samuel was mad. I don't blame him because God was mad. Saul was rebellious against God and disobedient. Look what he said. 1 Samuel chapter 15, verse 23 says, for rebellion, hear that? For rebellion, see, look how Israel rebelled against God. Many of you children are rebelling against your mother and father. Many of you are being rebellious against your husband and your wife, against your pastor, against leadership who are righteous. That's a form of witchcraft. Look what it says. For rebellion is as the sin of witchcraft. As stubbornness is as iniquity and idolatry. Wow, that's deep, y'all. Let's get into the word of God. Praise God for the Prince of Peace. Witchcraft is Satan's realm, and he excels in counterfeiting, hallelujah, what God does. The devil is a copycat. He's a counterfeit. He imitates God, but he cannot duplicate God, but he imitates him. He works with magic, which is a counterfeit of the anointing. Magic. Oh, I feel the Holy Ghost right now. Thank you, Jesus. Magic does not break or destroy the yoke, but it's the anointing, hallelujah, who is the power of God, which destroys the yoke, not magic. Magic deals with witchcraft. That's why you shouldn't deal with Harry Potter. All that stuff is sorcery. God is against witchcraft, magic. A lot of folk in the church are dealing with that stuff.
You can't serve two masters. Ain't no such thing as a Christian witch. Either you a Christian or you a witch. There's no such thing as a Christian witch. You can't serve the devil and Jesus at the same time. We can love Jesus, you don't shake hands with the devil. Because Jesus said, no man can serve two masters. Amen, somebody. Love the one and hate the other. No such thing as a Christian witch, not even in the Bible. Don't be deceived. The devil done lied to you. It is. Witchcraft is Satan's realm, and he excels in counterfeiting what God does. He's a copycat because he wants to be like God. He's jealous of God. He tried to take God's place and glory, but God cast him out. Nobody can take God's place. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. He's Alpha and he's Omega. Praise the Lord. He's the beginning and the end, the first and the last. Jesus said, I am the root and the offspring of David. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. I'm the bright and the morning star. Nobody can take God's place. Thank God for the Prince of Peace. So God, so the devil's mad because he wants to be God. He's jealous of God. So he imitates what he cannot duplicate. God gave Israel Sabbath day, which is on a Saturday. The devil copied it. Now he gave his devil worshipers something called Black Sabbath. See, the devil copycats. He imitated the Star of David, the star with a circle around it, where Satan worshipers got something called a pentagram with a star with a circle on it. He got that from the Star of David. See how the devil imitates God? We take communion, which represent the death, burial, and resurrection of Jesus Christ. The wine represent the blood of Jesus, and the bread represent the body of Jesus. So we take communion to commemorate the death and burial and resurrection of Jesus, how he died for our sins, how he shed his blood on the cross of Calvary to wash away our sins so we can have eternal life. So the wine represent the blood of Jesus, and the bread represent the body of Jesus that was broken for you. And the wine represent the blood of Jesus that was shed for you and me. Praise the Lord, my brother. God bless you today. Happy to see you this morning. Have a good day. Hallelujah. God bless you. And God bless all the cops and the firemen. May God bless you. He loves you. And may God save you and fill you with the Holy Ghost. Now look, in the devil worshiping world, they believe drinking blood gives them more power. Look how they copied off the communion. Look, hear this. There's power in the blood of Jesus. Hear that? Power in the blood of Jesus. Hallelujah. Healing in the name of Jesus. There's power in the blood of Jesus. His blood washes away our sins. His blood that he shed on the cross for you and me, because he loves us. He don't want to see us go to hell. Praise the Lord. Jesus became our high priest. Jesus became our redeemer. Jesus is our savior. So he laid down his life. He said, I have the power to take it back up again. And that's just what he did. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. To redeem us from our sins. The devil worshipers, they drink blood, but in a wicked and evil and corrupted way. They believe that when they drink blood, they get more power. That's a lie. The devil done lied to you. To you devil worshipers. He done lied to you. The devil copied off God. He copied off Jesus' blood. Because there's power that's in the blood of Jesus. Oh, hallelujah. We've been washed by his blood. But Jesus is pure, holy, and righteous, and not corrupted. The Bible speaks against witchcraft in Exodus chapter 8, verse 7. It says, at the heart of witchcraft is the desire to know the future. God is against fortune tellers. Fortune tellers. Remember the damsel in the book of Acts chapter 16 who is possessed with the spirit of divination. Paul knew that spirit was not of God, so he cast it out. Fortune tellers, psychics, tarot cards, all deal with witchcraft. God is against it. Read the book of Exodus chapter 8 verse 7. At the heart of witchcraft is the desire to know the future, God is against it, and control events that are not ours to control. God is in control, not us. Those abilities belong only to the Lord. You said that. This desire has its roots in Satan's first temptation to Eve. You can be like God. The devil lied to Eve. So you can be like God. Nobody can be like God. There's only one God. God is perfect. We're not perfect. That's why Jesus came to wash away our sins. Though God did make Adam and Eve to be holy, God did create Adam and Eve to be perfect. He did create them to be holy. The only time they became imperfect is when they sinned against God. Now, they was capable of being imperfect. They was capable of being disobedient. When the serpent came to Eve and told Eve, you could eat that tree, or that fruit, rather, other tree. You could be as God, but nobody can be exactly like God. There's only one God. He went to the weaker vessel. The Bible says that the woman is a weaker vessel. What it means is that she's more emotional than the man. It doesn't mean she's weak in the way we define it. Because women are very strong. Many of you women have taken care of children when the man was not around. I'm not talking about that source of weakness. When the Bible says that she's a weaker vessel, what it means is she's more emotional than the man. You can use that emotion in a good way or a bad way. That's why when women cry to God, God hears your prayers. Because God is honored by your tears. God is honored by the tears. Jesus is moved by tears. That's why women cry to God, Jesus is moved. He's honored by your tears. That's why as men should learn, when David cried to the Lord, David said, he heard my cry. Hallelujah. I know David was a warrior. God used David to slay Goliath, the big giant. But David knew how to cry to the Lord. Praise the Lord. And David said, he heard my cry. Tears move the heart of God. Hallelujah. That's why when women cry to God, God answers. Praise the Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. So, the serpent came to Eve. She got deceived. Then she persuaded Adam. And they ate of the fruit that God told them not to eat. And they were cast out the Garden of Eden. So every baby that was born under the curse of sin. But thank God for Jesus, who came to break the curse. When he shed his blood on the cross, on the tree. You don't have to take no LSD. Jesus came to set you free. Drugs is a form of witchcraft. Demons are in heroin. Demons are in crack. Bad things happen when you take crack and drugs and LSD. Let the Lord set you free. You don't have to take no LSD. Jesus can give you the victory. You don't got to take no drug overdose. All you need is a Holy Ghost. Oh, Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. These days, you don't know who's a witch. Not all witches and warlocks look like a witch. Notice in The Wizard of Oz? Well, this is the wizard. The wonderful Wizard of Oz. Now, we used to love to watch The Wizard of Oz when we was kids. Judy Garland, and Dorothy, the Tin Man, the Scarecrow, the Cowardly Lion. And we didn't see nothing to it because it was just a fairy tale to us. Now, as I began to grow, the Lord began to show me there was witchcraft even in that movie. Wizardry and sorcery. Crystal balls and Illuminati signs. And Freemason signs. And even Judy Garland was going through stuff on the set. She even got abused. So sad. Y'all didn't know she got abused by those munchkins. They was putting their hands under her dress doing the taping of The Wizard of Oz. Y'all didn't know that. She was being abused. Sexually abused. They wanted the munchkins. Y'all didn't know. Study the history. The documentary. I taught it before. One of the munchkins committed suicide. That was the year of the Great Depression. Back in the 1930s, 40s, or 50s, I believe it was. back in the 1930s, I believe it was. I'm gonna study it. I'll get the correct date in the future. But I know that was the year of the Great Depression, way before the Ten Commandments came out in 1957. They made the movie The Wizard of Oz. And they played the little dog Toto more money than they did the Munchkins. And instead, one of the Munchkins committed suicide on the set and hung himself. I did a study. This actually happened. So they had to block out that part off the set. They showed it when Dorothy and the Tin Man and the Scarecrow was dashing down the Yellow Brick Road. Follow the Yellow Brick Road. They showed the Munchkin in the background hanging from a tree and committed suicide. So there was magnifying witchcraft on the set, and bad things began to happen. Because demons, the devil, come to steal, kill, and destroy. But Jesus said, I come that you might have life and that you might have it more abundantly. So when they had magic on the set, you hear me closely, it opened up portals for demons to make bad things happen to Julie Garland. Praise God. That's why I want to keep my eyes on Jesus. Keep your eyes on the prize, and God will bless you. Not Ouija boards, not Ouija boards. God bless you, young woman. I'm happy to see you this morning. I've been praying for you. Praise God. Continue, the Lord, to bless her and her daughter. God bless you in the name of Jesus. Give her good nights. Give her good sleeps at night, God. Thank you, Jesus. So when they had the witchcraft on the set, all that magic was going on. It made bad things happen on the set. Praise the Lord. God bless you, my brother. Thank you so much. Hallelujah. He said, preach, preacher Warren. Somebody loves the word of God. Hallelujah. Now watch what happened on the set. Even the one who played the witch on The Wizard of Oz got burned. Remember that part when she came out the floor and the fire went up? She actually got burned up in real life. So she couldn't act in months. Then she came back. Bad things was even happening to the one who even acted the part of the wicked witch. So when you magnify the devil's tools, the devil will come against you because you're messing with his tools. Why you think God said regard not them? It makes sense. That's not hard to understand. It makes sense, right? That's why he said regard not them who have familiar spirits, neither seek after the wizards. Hallelujah. Wizards are male witches. God is against witchcraft. God is against magic. He said, don't seek after those people. Don't seek after the Ouija boards or the tarot cards. Those people deal with demons. That's why bad things happen. In the world, they call it bad luck. In the Bible, they call it a curse. God wants to bless you, not curse you. The worst curse you can ever suffer is when you disobey God. I don't want God to curse me. I want to be blessed. Read the book of Deuteronomy chapter 28. Verse 1 to verse 15. It said, if you do not obey God's holy word, you'll be cursed. God not trying to force you to obey him. He don't want to see you go to hell. Praise God for the Prince of Peace. That when you obey him, that when you keep his commandments, he'll bless you. But when you go outside of his word and begin to do things that makes God mad, like Israel did under Moses, God destroyed many of them because of their rebellion against God. Look what the Bible said. Rebellion is as a sin of witchcraft.
Bluetooth mode.
Many of you got witches and warlocks on your job. There are witches in the church. You got witches and warlocks even on the pulpit who do sorcery like Jim Jones, who deceive all those people to drink poison. He was a false prophet. They followed Jim Jones. Jesus said, if the blind lead the blind, they're all going to fall in the same ditch. He was a sorcerer. He reminded me of Simon the sorcerer. In the book of Acts, chapter number 8, who bewitched the city. And so God sent the apostles to break the curse when they preached about the baptism of Jesus' name. When they preached about the Holy Ghost, Jesus said, after the Holy Ghost has come upon you, you shall receive power. His power is greater than sorcery. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus.
Hallelujah. His power is greater than magic. Oh, oh Lordy, Lord. Ah, I feel Jesus. When the apostles began to preach in the city, the curse was broken off the people. Praise the Lord, my brother. God bless you this morning. God save him. God bless him, Lord, and save him. Praise God for the Prince of Peace. Jesus is the answer for the world today. The curse was broken. Hallelujah. When they preached the gospel of Jesus Christ. Simon the sorcerer sorcerized and bewitched the city. He's a sorcerer. There's different forms of witchcraft. Manipulation. Seduction. Jezebel was a witch. Come on. Read the book of Revelation chapter number 2 verse 20. God was against the angel of the church. The angel of the church was talking about the pastor of the church, not God's holy angels. Pastors are also called angels. He told the pastor of the church, he said, I have a few things against thee, because thou suffer that woman Jezebel. Men could be Jezebels too, not just women. You got a lot of men Jezebels who are playboys, who don't want to pay no child support, making all these babies, having sex with every girl he prayed for. You got men Jezebels and women Jezebels. But God was against the pastor of the church. He said, I got a few things against thee. Revelation chapter 20, verse, chapter 2, rather, verse 20. Because thou suffer that woman Jezebel,
see,
who calleth herself a prophetess.
She called herself a prophetess. God didn't call her to be no prophetess. She called herself, the devil ordained her to be a prophetess, a witch.
She went around seducing God's servants. Says she caused my servants to commit fornication. She went around seducing pastors in the church. She went around with miniskirts and all her breasts was out. Wearing seductive clothing in the church. We're living in days now in the church world. Women are dressing very seductive. And why would you want to do that in church? All your nipples out, all your breasts out to go around seducing preachers. You go around trying to seduce another woman's husband. We're living in days women are dressing more half naked in church more than ever. You think you're going to a strip club and not a church. Now you can't even tell a church from a strip club. Oh, come on, you know what I'm talking about. It is a spirit of witchcraft, seduction, lust is another form of witchcraft. Even in the gospel music world, a lot of women are dressing seductive.
Now, how are you singing about Jesus and all your nipples and breasts out? You don't have to do that, daughter. You're already beautiful.
God said, be holy, for I am holy. Present your body as a living sacrifice. Holy and acceptable unto God. You're already God's daughter. You're God's son. You're already beautiful. You don't got to dress half naked to get a man. Let a man love you for yourself. When God give you a husband, he'll love God first and he'll know how to love you. Come on. When God give you a wife, she's not a knife. She's a virtuous woman. Now you can love each other, but love God more. A marriage who pray together will stay together. A family who prays together will stay together. But when you dress seductive, women come to church dressed seductive.
Why? Not only to seduce men.
Some of y'all want to seduce women. We're living in those days now. It's a seducing spirit. That's another form of witchcraft.
So I know you're singing about Jesus. Oh, I love you, Jesus. And you're preaching about Jesus, but God is not pleased with your dress code. Why? It's seductive. The Bible said to abstain from the very appearance of evil. We're trying to help you because God loves you.
We're trying to help you because God loves you. He don't want to see you be lost in hell. He loves you. He don't want to see you go to hell. The devil do. That's why I thank God for his word. Man shall not live by bread alone, but by every word that proceedeth out of the mouth of God. When you obey him and keep his commandments, you'll be surprised how God will bless you. If you got a weakness, give it to God and say, Lord, help me. If you got a problem with lust and pornography, say, Lord, help me. I give it to you. I need your grace. I need your help. Wash away my sins. Forgive me, Lord. I repent.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. The Bible talks about the women's dress and modesty and modest apparel. Let's go to the scriptures. Let's go into God's word. They know how to teach this in church the way they used to. That's another form of witchcraft. Jesus was against Jezebel, against the pastor, because he allowed her to become an evangelist in the church. The head missionary went around seducing God's servants, men Jezebels too. He allowed it. Why? Because he was put under a spell of seduction. He was lusty. Women's dress in modesty. God bless you. We pray for you. You're doing a wonderful job. We thank God for you. We thank God for her. Consider the Lord to bless her as she fight crime here in New Jersey. Protect her, God, and all the cops here who's fighting crime here in New Jersey. Save her. Fill her with the power of your Holy Spirit. Bless him, Lord. Bless her, Lord. Bless him, Lord. Bless her, Lord, and save them. Let's go to the word of God. Look what it says here. Let's go to praise the Lord for the Prince of Peace. That women should dress in modesty and modest apparel. Praise the Lord for the Prince of Peace. Women should dress in modesty. Praise God for the Prince of Peace. 1 Timothy chapter number 2, verse 9. Here it says, that's why the mother should teach the young ladies how to dress virtuous. Hear what it says. Watch this. Let's go to the King James Version. In like manner, also that the women adorn themselves in modest apparel, with propriety and moderation, not with braided hair, our gold, our pearls, our costly array. You're already beautiful. It's about the inner beauty. The Bible talks about the virtuous woman. And Proverbs chapter 31, it talks about the virtuous woman. Not only she's beautiful on the outside, but she's beautiful on the inside, which is more important, the inner beauty. You're already beautiful. You don't got to dress seductive. You're already beautiful. It's about the inner beauty. When you love Jesus, you're already beautiful. When it says, let your light so shine, that others may see your good works, that the Father may be glorified through his Son, Jesus. Why was God angry at the pastor of the church for allowing her to have her way like that? Because she was a witch, went around seducing God's servants with a spirit of lust and seduction. Lust is the most powerful demon out here. Praise the Lord, my brother. God bless you. Hallelujah. It's lust, especially in the summertime. Oh, you already know half-naked bodies are going to be out here in the summer. Many of you are searching for love, but just all in the wrong places. Many of you never got love growing up. Many of you been molested, raped, and sexually abused, so you never experienced love. First of all, it's not your fault that you got molested, so don't blame yourself. Many of you are feeling dirty because some nasty pervert might be your father, or your brother, or your uncle, or your cousin, might molested you. It's not your fault that you got molested, so don't blame yourself. God loves you. I'm going to pray that God will heal your broken heart from the past. That's why many of you became promiscuous. See, showing cleavage. Many of you got molested and raped. That's why many of you became promiscuous. You were sexually abused when you was a child. So now you're searching for love, but all in the wrong places, but it's making it worse. Because you're laying with all these men and women, and you can catch a disease if you're not careful. Herpes, AIDS, God forbid. Many of you don't take protection. I want to teach you, because you're searching for love that you never had. You don't feel good about yourself because you was molested, because you was raped. You're hurt. You've been abused. Jesus is the answer. Some of you may say, well, that's hard to receive that, because you say, well, if Jesus loved me so much, why did he allow me to be raped? You say, if Jesus loved me so much, why did he allow me to be molested? So he became bitter against God. You don't want to hear it. You say, if God loved me so much, then why did he not stop my father or my cousin or my brother from molesting me when I was a girl, I was a boy? So now you don't believe in God. God understands why you're bitching. Jesus knows what it's like to be abused. He's been there. But he overcame. You can overcome too. I'm going to pray that God will heal you from the past so you won't go into witchcraft and the promiscuous behavior, which can get you into more trouble. The devil want to get you into drugs, crack, alcohol. It's a form of witchcraft. That's not the way. Jesus is the way, the truth, and the life. Oh, Lord, and no man that comes to the Father but by him. There's so many witches and warlocks in church, outside of church. Many of you got witches in your family working against you. Your own sister, or your own brother, or your own mother jealous of you. How could you be jealous of your own son? How could you be jealous of your own daughter? Parents, you're supposed to bless the child, not crush your child. Life and death is in the power of the tongue. Something wrong with you jealous of your own child? Come on, somebody. But they ask to be born in this world. You got your own mother who are witches who don't want to see you be happy in your marriage and try to break up your marriage. Many of you young men are being controlled by your mother who don't want to see you happy with your wife. Some of you got people who are jealous of you and your family. Praise the Lord, my brother. God bless you. Happy to see you this morning. God bless that young man. Some of you are mama's boys. Uh-oh. Don't turn that down. What's a mama's boy? I'm not saying don't love your mother. I'm not saying that. But do not let your mother control you. Respect her, but don't let her control you. And she's a mother who's envious and mean and jealous. The Bible talks about that. Let's go into the scriptures. That's another form of witchcraft, a controlling spirit. The Bible says, fathers, which includes mothers, provoke not your children to anger. They don't preach that in church. We just taught children obey your parents in the Lord. I agree. Honor your father and mother. Yes. But do not provoke your children to anger. Many of you are provoking your children to anger. Jealous of your own son. Jealous of your own daughter. Now that's wicked. How are you jealous of your own child and doing witchcraft against your own child? Look what the Bible said, Ephesians chapter 6, verse 4. Fathers, which includes mothers, preach, Holy Ghost. Provoke not your children to wrath. They don't teach that in church. They got a lot of these old wicked, evil mothers in church who call themselves missionaries, but you are really a witchinary. Different between a witchinary and a witchinary. Difference between a missionary and a witchinary. Many only have a form of godliness, but denying the power. If you're causing dissension in the church, if you're trying to break up somebody's marriage, that's a form of witchcraft. Many of you have mothers, young men, who don't want to see you happy with your wife. She's against her daughter-in-law. Now you must have your own mind. Love your mother, respect your parent, but don't let your mother control you and break up your marriage. If you know God gave that woman to you to be your wife, do not let your mother cause you to turn against your wife. Sometimes you got folk in your family who don't want to see you happy in a relationship. Their marriage is messed up and they don't want to see your marriage work. So be careful who you tell your business to. Everybody laughing in your face, it's not your friend. They stabbing you in the back. Like Judas betrayed Jesus. They're witches and warlocks. Going down to witch doctors. Trying to put a curse on you. But I'm stopped by to tell you, don't worry. Hallelujah. I hear the Lord saying, no weapon, praise the Lord, that is formed against you shall prosper. Will you keep your eyes on Jesus? Hallelujah. Will you keep your eyes on the prize? It won't work. But be wise. While you keep your eyes on the prize, be wise. Even Jesus said, be wise as serpents. In other words, be aware. Watch and pray. Don't tell your business to everybody. Everybody shaking your hand and laughing in your face doesn't mean they're your friend. You got witches on the Facebook. Lima called monitors. The devil works through Facebook, Instagram. Some come to monitor you. Everyone who friend requests you doesn't mean that they want to be your friend. Amen, somebody. Some just want to monitor you and know your business so they can sit out demonic spirits to cause nightmares and know where you live at and all this evil stuff that they practice at nighttime, 2-3 in the morning. How you sitting up 2-3 in the morning practicing witchcraft against people and think God don't see it and think God ain't gonna get you? What goes around comes around. Come on. You live by the sword, you die by it. There are folk who literally sit up late at night with the voodoo dolls and statues up there trying to put curses on people. And now you wonder why bad things happen to you. Because you're always trying to make bad things happen to somebody else. So you reap what you sow. So when you bless somebody, blessings will come back to you. When you bless people, blessings will come back to you. Then God will bless you when you bless others. When you do evil to people, evil will come back. So do good and not evil. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. You do that witchcraft? That's why when some people come to me and say, oh, preacher, why and pray for me? I'm just going through. Well, first of all, why are you going through? Are you going through for righteousness' sake? Are you going through for the name of Jesus? Apostle Peter said, let not a man suffer as a busybody. Let not a man suffer as a nosy person. Look what it says in the book of Peter. Are you suffering because you didn't practice witchcraft against somebody's marriage and it backfired? And that's why bad things are happening to you. They don't preach this too much in church. Let not a man suffer as a busybody. Hallelujah. Look what it says. Praise God. Praise the Lord, my brother. Happy to see you this morning. You too blessed and too anointed. All right now. Shooting very soon. All right. Have a good day, my brother. God bless you. Thank you. God bless you too. And may God save you and feed with the power of the Holy Ghost. He loves you. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Look what it says. Let's go into the word of God. Peter said, let not a man suffer as a busybody. Apostle Peter said, let not a man suffer as a busybody. 1 Peter chapter 4, verse 15. Look what it said. But let none of you suffer as a murderer, or as a thief, or as an evildoer, or as a busybody. Look. Those are nosy people. And other men's matters. See? Hallelujah. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. He said, don't suffer as a nosy person. Don't suffer as a busybody. Now, if you're nosy doing witchcraft against people, that's why those bad things are happening. Because what goes around comes around. When you do good, good will come back to you. When you bless somebody, blessings will come back to you. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Well, you do evil. Well, you're sitting up doing voodoo late at night and doing witchcraft. And got all this doing black magic against people. Especially when you work against a child of God. You're messing with the wrong people. Okay, man of God. Have a good day, my brother. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. That stuff backfires. Now you're getting sick. You're getting into car accidents. Your marriage is breaking up. You say, I don't know why all these things are going on, because you're doing witchcraft. God is against it. And God's wrath is even more dangerous because God is against witchcraft. Praise God. There are witches and warlocks who come looking nice, beautiful, handsome. The devil come as an angel of light. He don't come looking like Freddy Krueger. The devil will come looking handsome. The devil come looking beautiful. But he's wicked on the inside. Find the inner beauty. Don't just go by the outer beauty. Look for the inner beauty. The inner beauty is more important. Hallelujah. Let the Lord cleanse your heart. Ask God forgiveness for your sins. and say, Lord, come into my heart and save me, or else you're going to die and go to hell. Because witches and warlocks are not going to heaven. It's wicked. Who are you to judge? It's true. You have a chance to repent and come to Jesus right now. Many of you are dealing with family members who are controlling you. Have your own mind. Listen to wise people, not foolish people. Have your own mind. A wise man, a wise woman will listen to a wise man and a wise woman. Because you're wise enough to know that they're wise and we are still learning. We don't know everything. The fear of the Lord is the beginning of knowledge. Proverbs chapter 1, verse 7. Spend time in the presence of the Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Then God will give you the gift of discernment to know who's doing witchcraft. Someone to give you things. They put spirits on it. Come on. Spirit of manipulation and mind control. You mama boys, respect your mother, but don't let your mother turn you against your wife, especially if she's a good wife and she's a virtuous woman. Praise God. Love your wife as Christ loved the church. Love your husband. Love your children, but love God more. He comes first. Thank you, Jesus. You allowing your sister to manipulate you. You allow your mother-in-law to manipulate you. They're very controlling, evil and jealous, bossy with the mouth, very deceptive. They want to rob and steal from you. There are different forms of witchcraft. You got to be careful. Be aware. Watch and pray. Live holy every day, and God will show you things. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Thank you, Jesus. He'll say, the Lord will tell you, don't talk to that one on the phone. They put spirits through the phone to try to drain you. Putting out demonic forces. That's why you must have the whole armor of God. Thank you, Jesus. That you may be able to stand against the wiles of the devil. Once you got the Holy Ghost, God is your shield. He's your protection. David said that the angels of the Lord encamp about those who fear the Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. The weapons of our warfare is not carnal, but they mighty through God are to the pulling down of strongholds. Call the name of Jesus. Power in the name of Jesus. Healing in the name of Jesus. Praise the Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Woo! Demons are running right now. That voodoo spirit is going right now. I'm going to pray right now. We command demonic forces to go back to the abyss. The marine spirits. The lusting spirits. Many of you have been raped and sexually abused. God heal that broken heart. In the name of Jesus. Get rid of mind control. And the controlling spirits. And the spirits of sorcery. God is breaking generational curse. Now let's take it further. God is destroying that generational curse. It's the anointing that will destroy the yoke. Thank you, Jesus. Many of you are bound by Masonic curses. You had Masons and Eastern stars in your family who are worshiping Baphomet and doing witchcraft. And the curse passed on the third and fourth and fifth generation. Now you wonder why you have cancer. Or bad things are happening. Or you have heart attacks. Or your marriages don't last long. Are there blockages in your life? Are there hindrances in your life? Are you having nightmares? We come against nightmares. Set them free, God. Deliver them, Jesus. Heal, set free, and deliver. Heal that broken heart. Set them free from nightmares. Set them free from drugs. Set them free from drug addictions, God. Set them free from child molesters. Set them free from child abuse. In the name of Jesus, dispatch your holy angels in the schools. We come against gun violence. Hallelujah. Protect the people. Hallelujah. Throw away the Grand Theft Auto. Video games. That's a form of witchcraft. Stop watching demonic cartoons. A lot of these demonic movies open up doors for demons. Read God's holy word. He loves you. He loves you. And he come to set you free. Some of y'all got molested when you was a girl. It's not your fault that you got molested, so don't blame yourself. Jesus loves you, and God will heal your heart today. It's a form of witchcraft. Break the spirit and mind control off of God's people. Take your hands, Satan, off of God's people. In the name of Jesus, we speak blessings. 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 We speak blessings, not curses. Blessings upon God's people. Healing on God's people. We come against migraine headaches. Make cancer disappear. Make arthritis disappear. Hallelujah. Make asthma disappear. In the name of Jesus. Make our sins disappear. Those witches and warlocks who are in a pact with the devil. You have a chance to come to Jesus. Jesus can break the contract that you signed with the devil in your own blood. Anton LaVey, who started the Satanic Church years ago, did not know that when he was on his deathbed, he said, "What's wrong?" He kept saying, "What's wrong? Something is wrong." He felt a demon grabbing his spirit by his leg to pull him into hell. That same devil that he magnified was the same devil who destroyed him and took his soul to hell. Satan doesn't care about you. All he wants is your soul. That's why Jesus said that the thief cometh not but to steal, kill, and destroy. But Jesus said, "I come that you might have life, and that you might have it more abundantly." Hold on, my high emotion. All he wants is your soul. He'll give you fame and fortune. He'll make you rich and famous for your soul. But Jesus said, "What profit a man if you gain the whole world and lose his soul?" Hallelujah. Mark chapter 8, verse 36. It's not worth selling your soul for fame and fortune when Jesus can bless you himself. When Jesus can supply your every need. When you're seeking first the kingdom of God and all his righteousness, that all these things shall be added unto you, he will supply. But don't worship money. Don't put money above God. Don't make money your honey. Make God your honey, and he'll bless you with money. For the love of money is the root of all evil. It didn't say money is evil. It said the love of it. When you begin to worship money, you do evil things. You become greedy for money. Praise God. And the devil will laugh at you. We have your soul in hell. The same devil that you was worshiping is the same devil who will laugh at you if you take your soul to hell. Don't follow Satan. Follow Jesus. He's the one who loves you. He's the one who can give you eternal life when you repent from your sins and let the Lord live within. You'll be saved by grace and through faith. Jesus can break the contract that you signed with the devil, but it's up to you. If you choose to be rebellious against God, hell would be your portion. And the lake of fire, which is even worse than hell. We're not trying to scare folk to Jesus, but hell is scary. The lake of fire is scary. Tomorrow is not guaranteed to you or me. The next moment is not guaranteed to you or me. Hallelujah. That's why God said today, if you hear my voice, harden not your heart. Because we're all going to stand before God one day. Our Creator, Hebrews chapter 9, verse 27. Said is appointed for men once to die, but the end is judgment. Where will you spend eternity if you was to die today? Heaven or hell? There's no purgatory. The lake of fire is even worse than hell. The Bible talks about hell in the book of Isaiah chapter 5 verse 14. It said hell has enlarged herself without measure. The lake of fire is even worse than hell. Honey, I don't want to go to hell or the lake of fire. I want to be with Jesus when he comes back. Most of my friends got shot in the hood back in Harlem where I was born at. I done preached to me furious. And my friends who got shot on the basketball court, the next moment is not guaranteed to us. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Have a relationship with God. He loves you. He loves you. He don't want to see you perish. He loves you. He can wash away your sins with his precious blood, so your name can be written in the Lamb's book of life. Hallelujah. And John said, "And I saw death and hell cast in the lake of fire." Revelation chapter 20, verse 14. Where your name is in the book of life, you will have eternal life to be with Jesus Christ. He'll give you eternal peace. Because one day God will destroy this world. For God is angry at the wicked every day. The fearful and the unbelieving shall have their part in the lake of fire. Believe in him, and he'll give you eternal life to be with Jesus Christ. I'm gonna say a prayer of faith right now. We have some drug addicts who came to Jesus on this week. An alcoholic came to Jesus on this week, and the Lord set the man free from alcohol and depression. God can give you a better drink than Jack Daniels and corn liquor. Hallelujah. That's the living water. Whoa. The living water, which is Jesus Christ. And Jesus said, out of your belly shall flow rivers of living water. He'll give you joy that drugs cannot give you. You don't need no drug overdose. All you need is a Holy Ghost. Oh, Lord, thank you, Jesus. Let's pray. Father, in the name of Jesus, there's those who's watching me around the world on YouTube. Hear your word being preached. Your word is life. Your word is power. It's healing. It's sharper than any two-edged sword. Piercing the dividing asunder of the soul and the spirit and the joints and the marrows. And is a discerner of the intents of the heart. Break the spirit of witchcraft. Destroy it. Sorcery. Lust. Hallelujah. Don't let us be deceived, God. Help us to be aware and stay in your word. God was angry at the... God has something against the pastor of the church because he allowed the woman Jezebel to go around seducing God's servants. He said, I gave her space to repent. But she repented not. God even gave Jezebel time to repent. But she never did. She said, behold, I will cast her into her bed with them who commit adultery with her, except she repent of her deeds. A lot of you pastors have been seduced. A lot of you women have been seduced because he's good looking, because he's a preacher. Huh? The devil come as a preacher. The devil knows the Bible, but he doesn't live it. You've been seduced. You've been whipped. You've been bamboozled. You've been deceived. But Jesus can break the curse of sorcery. You fell in love with the wrong one. You gave your heart to a demon, a she demon, and a he demon, and it broke your heart. But Jesus can heal that heart. He's doing it right now. Give your heart to Jesus. Love him. Love him. He loves you. He loves you. He has an unconditional love, my highest son. I feel the spirit of the Lord right now. I feel the presence of the Lord right now. God is delivering somebody right now.